could share a little bit about how just the environment in here also kind of pushes towards that, towards like a positivity, art that's around here?
I mean, we created a youth center in our own image. You know, so all our values, our principles, like the things that we cared about, we wanted to make sure that it was promoted, you know, within the space. So like we have, you know, Malcolm, and someone came one time, you know, actually some people from the city, because we had city funding, and they said, well, they were offended. Some person said that they felt it was unwelcoming to see a Malcolm X image. This lady said that. And she said, why don't you have a Martin Luther King, you know? And we said, you know what? We love Martin Luther King. You know, we celebrate Martin Luther King Day. Like, we all go march, you know, we go to the events and all that as a staff, as a community. But Malcolm X went to jail and transformed his life and became one of the most powerful civil rights leaders, you know, in that era. And so we want to see the young people that are, a lot of them are going to jail, you know, to have that experience. So Malcolm X is more meaningful. Like Malcolm X for me, you know, being a young Chicano growing up in Santa Monica was my first real role model. Because even like Cesar Chavez, you know, I couldn't really relate. You know, he came from a rural community, that type of thing. But Malcolm came, you know, from an urban setting and, you know, hustling and drugs and all that type of thing. That poster right there is a former gang member who basically has a Norteño gang member killing a Sureño gang member, let's say, you know. And then Uncle Sam is puppeteering the gang member. And then every time he kills a gang member, he crosses off a Mexican hat. You see what I'm saying? To show like the government's behind a lot of this, and that's exactly the plot. You know, that's the plan. But see that poster right there, we have it up, and a lot of people will start talking about it. Or like this one right here shows these are four gangs on the west side that have beef with each other. So Culver City, Santa Monica, Sotel, and Venice. And so this one image right here shows all of these neighborhoods, you know, with peace, you know, flying through, and then the graveyard down here of all the death, you know. Right. And that piece right there, like you show that to any gang member, and they'll initially say like, oh, I don't like it, you know, because it shows like us united. But then it's a point like, why? Well, isn't that what happens when y'all go to prison? Like you can't beef, like in prison.
What you gonna do?
You can't beef in there. Like you go in there, all those neighborhoods, the gang members from all the different neighborhoods out here on the west side, when they go to the prisons, they can't beef with each other because in there it's between races, you know? Right. So like the Mexicans gotta, you know, the Sureños gotta roll together. Yeah. So it's interesting because out here they're killing each other, but inside they can't fight. You know, there's, you know, on the streets, like, you know, it's not supposed to happen, you know what I'm saying? Like the gang members, you know, the Latino gang members don't roll with the black gang members. Like it's just, that's one of the big divisions that has occurred since 1991 in Los Angeles, you know, and our community's been impacted too. But, you know, here with hip hop, it doesn't matter, you know, like we're able to cross the racial divide, you know, because of the music and because of the culture, which is all about celebrating diversity. And I don't care what color you are, if you got skills, come through, you know what I'm saying? And so that's what's beautiful about that, you know. And it's about, and it has a battle component too, so it's not for punks, you know what I'm saying?
Gotta be dope,
like hip, yeah, and you gotta have courage, you know. So
correct.
So it's like you gotta, all right, you know, like, you know, oh, I heard this, you know, there is a battle component, so you can get some of that stuff off of your chest through a cipher, through some competition or whatever, you know. But yeah, but it's been a great way for us to bring, you know, build community, you know, like through the music, through the culture, you know.
So our motto is peace, unity, and social justice. And peace, love, unity, having fun is Chris's, you know, the hip hop motto, you know what I mean?
Right,
so,
right.
So it's like, yeah, that's it. So we're definitely, you know, we're definitely about it.
And sometimes you like the main act, like when you're DJing at a party or an event, but sometimes you've also, you know, holding down an MC, like you hold down J-Roz. What are some other acts that you I know you had a chance to rock with KRS once.
Yeah. You know what? That's one of those turning points in my life where I felt like, oh man, this is what I want to do. You know, this is it right here. I feel so comfortable rocking with KRS, you know, that, oh, I could do it for anybody, you right. know? Like, that shit knighted me that night, you know? And it was me and J-Roz were opening for him that night. And me and Jay just came raw with the hip hop, you know? So at that point, when their manager saw what we were doing, he asked if I would DJ for KRS. Uh-huh. And I remember him just coming to the back of the room and seeing like, who's my DJ, you know?
Right, right.
And I'm just over here like,
Me, Mr.
Chris, teacher, right, you know, like right. Last master. Like I've been listening to you since I was this tall, and I'm just like, I was used to practice, you know, and I didn't crack down right. like that, you know. But homie just came up and he was like, these are how I rock my show. This is my formula. I'm not gonna give up the formula, but you know, this is what we do. This is what we do. And when I say this, you do that, and this and that. And from there, it was like going to school and going like, oh man, I'm at the Harvard of hip hop right now. You know, listening to this dude from the Bronx, who emanates that whole. The
and
essence.
He was able to break down the whole show. Like, y'all didn't even need no
rehearsal beforehand. Because a DJ knows what they do, right. And an MC does what they do, and that's how you know. And on stage, that's when he stopped the show one night, and he said, "That's a real hip hop DJ," you know, that moment was when I felt like the light, like, all right, cool,
right,
we can do this.
You're so united.
It was like a relief of belief, you know. It was like, oh, this is real. Like, we could really do this. Let's do this. Let's all have fun and keep doing this for the rest of our lives. As long as we can.
Definitely.
You know, and that leads into collaboration, not just from him, but. From J Ross, it stemmed on to Boca Floja, and then it went on to, I got to meet you guys, Rebel Diaz, you know what I'm saying? Right. Through the whole project with Boca, and then this other turn takes, and all of a sudden I'm rocking with Ana Tiju, and in between though, there's the people like here in LA, like Acid Rain, you know, just different people, Semiotics, everybody in the community that fill in everything else that build that pyramid that you know you stand on in one day.
For sure.
You know, so yeah,
and you've been rocking with Los Racas lately.
Oh man, that's right now is Los Racas. Yeah. Like, we're just moving, we're doing, they're doing their thing. We're gonna rock some good shows, you know. Coachella's coming up. We got that's a Coachella, big show, right. Coachella, you know, the festival where you dream about, like, if you ever go, you're just like, oh, you know, imagine someday playing here. Well, Los Racas are doing it. They have a great team, you know, they're doing their thing. They represent Oakland, Panama, California, just the whole movement of where we're all at, like immigrants, la diaspora, everybody, you know?
All coming together like...
Yeah, like Latinos is one. And not only that, but as human beings, when we're up there conviving with more than just Latinos, you know, and we're on stage and we're bringing everybody together through languages that sometimes they don't even understand.
We're in Los Angeles, California. We have DJ Ethos on the ones and twos. Let's go!
That's the sound that I'm police. That's the sound that I'm.